Okay, this is just a video I need to get up real quick. There are no intros, whatever. It's just something I need to get up real quick. It's addressing ZeroxRequiem. I'm going to cover as much stuff as I possibly can. And just let me just tell you, currently as I'm making the video, the account is closed. Again! But these are things that need to be addressed so people don't start getting misconceptions. First thing is regarding to the whole Sasuke sound closing the account in the first place. It's 50-50 on that. I'm not going to say he did. I'm not going to say he didn't. 50-50. What I want to address is some of what Strapped Up 24 said in his video that he just made, like, as I'm making this, he made this, like, I guess he uploaded this like about an hour ago, the way when I'm making the video. But let me just address some things. Okay. You're 24. I see you're trying to hit some defense on this because of Pepper Hand's video he made earlier, which to me was pretty fucking funny. And now I'm not saying Sasuke sounds a horrible person. I'm not saying you or him need to go burning. I'm not saying any of that. What I'm saying is that when you become a founder or creator of a collab channel, you gotta understand there's certain responsibilities you have, and you're trying, and you're like, and I see where you're coming from, and you do have a point that Pepper Ham could have contacted you and been like, why are we kicked? But I have proof. I'm going to show you on Naruto Rasengan D's channel. I think around the same day as ZeroxRequiem came back up, I think Naruto Rasengan D had gave Sasuke-san a link. This link helped him reopen the account. This is why I'm neutral with the whole him closing the account in the first place. It could have still happened. But I know from this much that he was not aware that you could reopen an account. Which makes me 50-50. That's besides the point though. Like, this is what pissed me off. It's just like, you didn't, in the fucking, alright, hold on, let me just show you this and I'll explain it. Alright, look. Naruto Rasengan D's channel. I'm gonna scroll down here if I can get the fucking mouse to scroll. Then I'm gonna show you the comment. Alright, here it is. So I sketched down 123. I'm gonna try to reopen the account. We're not going down that easy. This is what makes me think that maybe he didn't actually do this purposely. There's another comment from later saying, I think this was after ZeroxRequiem came back. He's like, I told you we would get it back. Oh, some of the members are out. You're still good. You're still in. Don't worry. Okay. I can go to Sasuke-san's channel and show you that Naruto Rasengan D left the link talking about said, where is it? I think it's on the next page. I'm trying to do this real quick so I can get all this, because there are other things I need to address, but okay, I'll click that. Where is it? Alright. He sent 3 days ago, he sent Sasuke-san like this Google link, I guess, which to reopen the account. Okay. That is the proof relating to that. I need to take the zoom out. Take the zoom out. Fuck. Alright, here we go. I got like 6 minutes left. Alright, here we go. Now to address the whole kicking people. When you are the leader of a fucking... Being a leader of a collab channel means you have certain responsibility. Like, to let us know what the fucking topic is before our day comes. Like, who the fuck wants to know about the topic of that week on their day? It's bullshit. You had that responsibility. And you also had the responsibility to ask people. You just kicked people. You didn't fucking ask anyone. You didn't ask, you didn't go, maybe they did or did not want to be back in. You just decided to out people. And you and Strapped Up 24 tries to defend it, saying, well, how do you know you were kicked? Okay. Sasuke-san blatantly told Naruto Rasengan D, as I just showed you, the day it came back up, the members were out. He had already predetermined kicking members out. So I'm supposed to believe that he wasn't going to kick members out. And then he posted a bulletin on ZeroxRequiem saying this shit and didn't email nobody. I mean, email or personal message anybody. And he still and didn't even make a fucking video talking about how he's getting people. He still doesn't address the issue of kicking people. Now, that legitimately just pisses me off, because you don't just, if you're going to be responsible for a fucking collab channel, you take responsibility when it comes to the rules, the topics, and addressing other members. Talking about how other members address in one another. You didn't do shit about that. You just closed the account. If you did, hint, half and half still. That's not how you go about things. As far as people getting pissed, they have every right to be. You didn't let them know. That was your responsibility as the friggin' founder, as you so-called call it. And now, I'm not saying you need to go to hell. I'm not saying I don't hate the channel. I don't give a fuck. I still probably watch the videos regardless. If the fucking account wasn't closed again through so-called troll bullshit, whatever. I don't give a fuck. It just annoyed me. What else? And it's just like, I guess the issues he was referring to in his video was maybe the slight issues that certain people didn't like other people. Pepper and Ham was cool. But I think the main issue I think he was referring to was the fact about Narsa Rasa Gandhi, because I've said this in blog TV things before, that I think half his videos are really monotone and boring and about the same shit. If this was what he was referring to, he didn't message anyone about this shit. As a fucking founder, you're supposed to make sure shit is straight. That's your job. It's like being a leader of a country and not doing shit. You have to have some type of authority. You literally just let shit run free. About that legitimately just pisses me off when you make fucking statements. And then the whole statement Strap the 24 made in his video talking about how about subs again, and Sasuke Sound did this on his own in the comments replying to Yokorama, talking about subs. Okay, Strap the 24, you said in your video you're kind of using this as a way to get to Japan, like to get sponsored and shit, so you can't fucking say that there wasn't any personal gain. Legitimately, subs does not mean better. Just because I have more subs than like X2B doesn't mean he still can't trump me in an intellectual debate. That doesn't mean shit. That's the problem Sasuke Sound kind of has. I've noticed this in just comments and shit. That if the person he's talking to who doesn't agree with him says some shit and backs it up but has less subscribers than Sasuke Sound, he's not going to take that shit seriously. He never really, I've never seen him do that. He has somewhat of an ego. That's where the whole ego thing comes from. And plus that, when you make a claim like ZeroxRequiem is going to be the best anime informational channel, that's not a fact, for one. That's a fucking opinion. It's only a fact when there's a clear consensus. And the overwhelming majority rules that that is a fact. It's not just a fact. And for such a great channel, what were we really doing? We did a fucking tsunami video, which has been overdone as hell. An introduction. A random video. What were we doing with Cartoon? The first few topics that just, we're talking about Cartoon Network, but we were doing such a great channel. It was such a fucking epic channel. Because it had 7 different viewpoints, even though some of that shit wasn't even opinion. It was just what you were doing, or it's like, I don't even remember half the topics. We had random video introduction, what were we doing? I actually don't remember the other one. That's like, we didn't have that many epic videos. You made it seem like we were this big channel, and maybe Sasuke Sound just couldn't come up with a fucking idea. That could have just been it. I don't fucking know or care. It's just don't fucking make statements like, you are the shit when you ain't, because you didn't fucking do what you were supposed to do. You guys had responsibilities to let us know of shit. We should not have been in the crowd of people like, what the fuck? Like what Pepper Ham said, if we're in the fucking band, so-called, we should not have been the last ones to hear about some shit. That was your responsibility as founders and co-founders. You failing to do that, don't take it out on us. You can't be surprised that we're pissed when you didn't do what the fuck you were supposed to do. Do I hate having ill feelings towards you guys? No. Do I think that was a dick move? Yes, but this is running over 10 minutes, and I gotta go. So, peace. Life is a game, play to win. I probably will take this video down later, but this is just something that needs to be addressed on my main channel. So, peace, guys. Woo! I'm just fucking with you. Peace.